Hello and welcome to TechEd. My name is Klaus-Peter Sauer and I work in the product management area of data warehousing at SAP, focusing on Data Warehouse Cloud. So today's session is about integrating HANA SQL Data Warehousing with Data Warehouse Cloud. And for that reason, I want to start off with our statement of direction slide of data warehousing overall, where we're going to focus today on the left-hand side on the yellow box, on the golden box, what you see there, SQL data warehousing, and the integration part, specifically with a hybrid scenario with Data Warehouse Cloud. So let's move into the section. And the first topic I want to highlight here is that there are different options of doing that kind of integration. On the one hand side, in a hybrid mode, as I just mentioned. So that means you would have an existing data mart or SQL data warehouse system separately from Data Warehouse Cloud and two separate databases. On the other hand, there is an option also now with Data Warehouse Cloud in the meantime that you can do both in an integrated fashion on one system. And that's what I'm going to explain you today, and you will see that in a demo. So let's directly move into the first scenario. So you have an existing data mart based on HANA, an existing data warehouse where you build stuff in SQL schemas or the HANA deployment infrastructure containers. You then have a second system, Data Warehouse Cloud, with the different layers, and the integration piece actually happens where you can connect both on the data layer, so SQL schemas as well as deployment infrastructure containers, and use the existing Data Warehouse Cloud editors to actually work with that data, right? And that's what you're going to see now in this first demo.
For the demo, I created a demo space called Black Forest. So let's have a look into it. I've created two connections here. One to a regular HANA system, to a database schema, and one to an HDI container. So for the HANA system, you just enter the connection details, select the database provisioning agent, user password. We can also check if the connection is working. So we have a valid connection. The connection details for the HDI container can be obtained from your HDI container. I can show you in Cloud Platform how that looks like. So we're now in the Cloud Platform and I see the Data Warehouse Cloud HDI sales demo container, which I created earlier. And when you go into the details, you find the service keys. And here you find the connection details to this HANA system. So hostname, port, and the user, as well as the password here. Please select the user with the ending runtime, RT, and use this connection data to connect to the HDI container. So back in Data Warehouse Cloud, I can use those connections. So for the HANA system, as well as for the HDI container, and start modeling. So I took for this one here, the sales order table you see from the remote SAP HANA connection, and as well the sales order items table also from that same remote system. You can also use, of course, the HDI container based artifacts like the tables here, which are coming from the HDI container connection, where I used also different source tables in there. You see it also on the right hand side, the connection comes from an HDI container with remote access. So in the HDI container, on the web IDE, you see exactly that Data Warehouse Cloud HDI sales demo data model with a calculation view, few source tables I have created there, and that is exactly what I have connected. You can also build a report on top of it, like the little report I created here in the Story Builder from SAP Analytics Cloud on top of the sales order view from the SAP HANA system, which I used earlier. So very simple one, which I created here. You can do whatever SAP Analytics Cloud gives you here from a functional perspective.
So now in the second scenario here, we're talking about an integrated scenario. So in the first part, it was like a separate system externally hosted somewhere or in your on-premise data center. And now this second scenario is basically, you can do the same thing, but in one integrated system. So with the tooling, you know, with the SQL editors or web IDE, whatever you use in order to build up your SQL schema, you can use the so-called OpenSQL schema in Data Warehouse Cloud to do the very same thing. In case you're using deployment infrastructure containers, that is a little more complex to set up, and that's why we have a more extensive demo now in the second stint here, where we're using Web IDE to build those containers in the underlying database of Data Warehouse Cloud. So one system in an integrated fashion, as I mentioned before, and you can also combine both approaches, right? That you can use the OpenSQL schema as well as the HANA deployment infrastructure containers, the HDI containers with your existing tooling, your SQL editors externally or the web IDE, whatever you prefer, and then integrate it into a Data Warehouse Cloud space and use the tooling, what you see here more to the right-hand side, those editors in Data Warehouse Cloud, like the Data Builder in the future, also in November, the Data Flow Builder and the Business Builder end of the year. That's why they have asterisks here. So this is according to our roadmap planned for the end of the year. And to show you everything there, we I recorded a demo where you can actually see that in more detail, how it looks like. So let's have a look at the demo.
In the demo, I'm going to show you now how you actually create such an open SQL schema I was talking about earlier. So you go to the space management area into your space. There's a section about database access, database users, and that's where you actually create one or multiple database schemas for this specific use, and you can specify whether you want it enabled for data ingestion, data consumption, or HDI, or all at the same time. What actually happens then is you enter a name. So in my case, I put DB Explorer in there, and you get then a database name, a password, which is generated automatically, and you get an endpoint, a host name in the cloud, and a port, and that's what you can use to connect with external tooling. You also get a user-provided service being generated, which you can copy then and bring it over to your cloud platform to connect that as well. So let me just show you quickly how you can connect here from other tools. I'm using in this case a tool called dBeaver. That's an open source tool in a community edition which can be downloaded and used. And I already did the connection using these details which were generated and connect to my system here. I connect then or get access to that DB Explorer OpenSQL schema. And what you see, I already created a database table in there with a regular create table statement. We have also data in there. So that's already preloaded. I did that beforehand. I can also create another one just right now based on a create table statement, Just go here and do the refresh, and then you will see it appearing. This one is obviously empty now. So this is an external tool, not from SAP. You can also use tooling from SAP. So that's also available. So if you're again here in the space management, you see here, if you check one of these OpenSQL schemas, the Open Database Explorer button on top of it. And if you're actually doing it, you get to the DB Explorer. So it opens up here, the Database Explorer from HANA in your browser. And you get pretty much the same access from what we've seen here in the other tool, the dbeaver tool. So you get access to the database tables which are in there. So now you see two, both which I created using the other tool. And I can create, of course, from here also another table, right, using a create table statement. And then those three actually show up, and you can do whatever DDL, DML statements you want to execute here in the SQL console, create views, tables, synonyms, procedures, etc. in one of those tools. Back on the Data Warehouse Cloud side, if I go into the modeling area, for example, here in the view editor, I can use those objects like regular tables, and I see here the OpenSQL schema being shown, and I see exactly these three tables which I have just created, or which has been there, the sales order table a little earlier, and I already used that in a model here, so I already included that, and you see here where it's coming from this local schema, and join it with data which sits in the system already. When you're interested to actually deploy HANA deployment infrastructure containers on Data Warehouse Cloud, you can actually do that as well. So in the space management section where we've been before, you see also there's an HDI container section where I could add HDI containers to a particular space. Of course, you have to have a container, and I can directly switch there in the web IDE. And I have created and prepared a project already there, which of course has to be mapped to the Data Warehouse Cloud system. So that's what I did beforehand. I also ran already the build process and created the container already. So the deployment of a container called HDI in Data Warehouse Cloud underscore schema one has been successfully completed. There's not a lot of data in there currently. I basically do reuse existing artifacts which I share from Data Warehouse Cloud. So there is a calculation view here available, which basically shows me two tables from Data Warehouse Cloud, which I actually access, sales order item integration table and a product integration table, which I join on the product ID, do the mapping here, and deploy that kind of calculation view. So what has to happen before is that you actually enable via synonym configuration here access to these artifacts either on the container, but also on the other hand, what is kind of exposed from Data Warehouse Cloud perspective. And when you actually do that, do the deployment and generate the container, you see on the cloud platform cockpit here that the container here has been deployed. And in Data Warehouse Cloud, we can now add this container. And we're looking for HDI in DWC schema one, right? That was the one which was actually created. I select this, and now it's basically registered in this space. And from the data builder perspective, if I want to now build a new graphical view, this pretty much shows up now under the sources tab. So next to the OpenSQL containers, which we have next to the source system connections, we also see now this HDI container, and it contains just one calculation view, right? So this is the one I can use and work with like with any other object in Data Warehouse Cloud and build on top of it and use it in combination with other different artifacts.
Okay, so after we've seen both different setups or scenarios in action, and in case you want to know more, there's a lot of content we provide from our product management team here to you externally. So first and foremost, our website, subdatawarehouse.cloud, where you find a lot of learning, onboarding guides, blogs, etc. Of course, there's a detailed help documentation. There's also a roadmap on our Roadmap Explorer, so everything linked here in the content. And if you want to provide feedback, of course, use the feedback QR code here on this slide and give us feedback on the product. We're looking forward to that. And in case you want to get your hands dirty, there's also a 30-day free trial available. Just register with your email address, and you will get a system provisioned within a few minutes here on this web page. And if you're interested on more stuff around Data Warehouse Cloud, we also offer various other sessions here at TechEd. So there's a hands-on session also done by me and a colleague from mine, Axel Meyer, ANA 369, for where you can actually check it out yourself in hands-on fashion. There are other sessions for integration with Data Warehouse Cloud and various layers, third-party applications, etc. So that's all valuable information where you can get more hands-on or information on the cloud and the learning experience, of course, with TechEd. So have a look here and activate your free access on the Learning Hub. You find the links here, subscribed to the Learning Hub if you like. That's all open for you. So I hope you enjoyed the session. And that's it from my side. Thank you very much and bye-bye.